We have two great Halo updates, one with MZC Season 6 and what you need to do to prepare for that launch on April 7th, as well as some Halo Infinite multiplayer news. So stay tuned throughout the whole video to understand all the details. So on Friday, we got a nice little development update for the MCC, just telling us what's going to be coming with Season 6 and where the stuff that's not going to be in Season 6 and where it's currently at the moment. We'll cover that in this video, as well as a new little addition for Halo Infinite event coming in later this year of 2021. So if you guys like these news and informational videos, make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. If you want to stay up to date with Halo as we ramp up to the release of Halo Infinite, make sure you tap subscribe. So let's get right into the content here. So for this video, let's start off with the news that's going to affect us immediately, and then we'll go into the Halo Infinite news later. So starting off with this, we all know now the announced date for the Season 6 release called Raven for MCC will be on April 7th, this coming Wednesday. Coming in with a bunch of new features, pieces of content, bug fixes, and as well as a new season to kind of just grind through 100 tiers of new unlocks for you to get as well with brand new customization. But there are a couple things you need to take in consideration when it comes to the release of Season 6. These are pretty standard. This has happened with every season previously, but it's good to know. So when that new season drops on April 7th, this Wednesday, you guys will be prepared. So one thing that's going to happen is the mid-mission checkpoints for all MCC games will be erased. So if you're in the middle of a mission, or if you're in the middle of a checkpoint in some kind of situation, that's going to be reset. So you'll have to go back to either your Alpha, your Bravo, your Charlie, or whatever kind of checkpoint you have for your mission in case you're kind of stuck in a section or something like that. So keep that in mind for your campaign players right there. Another thing which has happened in previous seasons as well is that all theater files created prior to this update will also become invalid. So that's a really important thing. So if you guys have any awesome clips you want to save for yourself, or you did something really great that you kind of want to just remember back at some point, you're going to need to find a way to record that or find a way to save it into an external service or some way or another. Another change is happening with the servers of the MCC as well. As they said, they're doing some efficiency changes for our global server infrastructure. 343 stated saying some subset of players may find they are now connecting to different server regions. They do say that this shouldn't really affect your gameplay experience while playing MCC, but you might find yourself connecting to different regions. Now, they don't really specify if they're adding new regions or removing some servers. My guess it probably would be removing, just because the population of MCC will be dwindling over 2021, just because, you know, there really isn't a whole lot of new extra content coming in. So I could see happening. Of course, they do say that it's not going to hopefully affect your experience too much. And they also stated that since there is a server region selection within the UI, you can choose exactly what servers you want to connect to. So this might be affecting more people probably outside of the US, if anything. But just a very important thing to know that when Season 6 rolls around, make sure you keep an eye on what servers you're connecting to. Season 6, now we're on to this part of the update. They talk about here saying there will be a full list of features that will be outlined in next week's Go Live blog. So on Wednesday, we'll definitely know more about exactly what's going live, but we have a pretty good idea of what's going to be added in there. But we'll have a concrete example on Wednesday when Season 6 does go live. I guarantee you, I'll be making plenty of videos about the MCC Season 6 as soon as that update does go live. But they do mention a lot of PC features will be coming over to the Xbox, like FOV slider for all Xbox consoles. For the Xbox Series S and X, when playing at 120Hz, the FOV will not be locked. So you have unlocked FOV slider for 120Hz on the new gen Xbox consoles. That's really great to hear, as well as some new audio options. Also keep in mind, we have the exchange coming in with Season 6. This is a basically kind of like a free MCC store, if you think of it that way. Essentially, they have a weekly rotation of things you can unlock utilizing seasonal points, and they have a new featured item as well within the exchange as well, where you can buy a whole package of things that with your seasonal points. Again, this will be completely free. There's not going to be any form of microtransactions. You just spend your seasonal points. This is essentially just like a way for people who haven't unlocked absolutely everything in the game and have a stockpile of different seasonal points you can utilize. This is the best way to do it, so then people can stay active with the game rather than unlocking everything within the season pass and then not playing MCC later on, you know, just coming back when the new season drops. Now, there are three things that people were really excited about Season 6 that will not be coming in. They do say that they'll be working with future flights with these three features, one being view model offsets. This is basically where you can place your weapon on the screen. Needs a little bit more time to get more feature robust is what they kind of mentioned here. The map Edge that we've had in the flight for Season 6, it's not going to be making it in just because it needs a little bit more time in the oven, to quote what Postums said about the map. And of course, I know the one that everyone's really excited about is the custom game browser that was not able to make it into the Season 6 flight. It will not be launching with Season 6, but they definitely will be trying to flight it. I would assume we'll probably get our hands on some custom game browser experiences probably mid-April. Because it sounds like the custom game browser is really close, it just has some flow issues when it comes to players getting in and out of the custom game browser, so it just needs a little bit more time to be worked on. Now, this next section, we'll be talking about some Halo Infinite multiplayer experience and when we can actually get some more information coming about this. So if you guys, I'm sure you're all aware that 2020 wasn't exactly the best year for Halo events. I was there for the Anaheim event, which was, now I'm like, super fortunate that I actually was able to make it to that one now, but we actually have our first confirmed Halo event happening in 2021, actually, which is really exciting. Tashi, the head of HCS for Halo, recently tweeted this out, saying, "Recently locked in date and venue for the first Halo Infinite HCS event, assuming safe to attend by then. It's in 2021, this year, operated by none other than Esports Engine. Details this summer. See you there." Now, you're probably thinking, okay, it's an HCS event, I don't care. But this actually is very important because they definitely will be tying in multiplayer information along with competitive side of things as well. So as soon as we know anything about multiplayer, we'll probably know stuff about the HCS as well at the same time. Meaning this summer we will definitely get some information about Halo Infinite's multiplayer. We do know that E3 will be happening in June. It'll be an all digital event, completely free for you to check out, which I'm really excited about that. We'll be covering E3 in depth because that's going to be a huge day for Halo Infinite content. I guarantee you we'll know a lot more about the campaign, that's for sure, but I'm pretty sure we'll also get some Halo Infinite multiplayer experience information, maybe a little bit on the flighting process as well. Now, this is going to be very interesting though. When they will hold this Halo Infinite event, will they hold it before the release of the game or after the release of the game? This makes me think this might be like a pre-release competitive event that we might have for Halo Infinite. As my previous videos have indicated, that it looks like Halo Infinite's release is going to be on November, most likely November 15th, to commemorate the 20th anniversary of Halo. So will this event happen within the month of November, maybe December? I feel like that's a little unlikely since it's very busy for families to try to coordinate times, because obviously it's the holiday season in America. And if they're gonna let us know within the summer of when this event's gonna happen, this makes me feel like it might be a pre-release event that you might see some competitive gameplay happening. This might be a little bit of like some social side of things as well, to utilize the grassroots program people as well. And it'll definitely would have to be probably in the fall time frame as well, as most people should be vaccinated by then as well, would make the event much more safer to go to as well. Again, as soon as we have more information within the summer, I'll let you guys know about more about this update. And if I can make it, I will 100% try my best to make it, because I love going to Halo events. I've gone to many of these, and it's a great way to meet up with a lot of Halo community members. So if you want to stay up to date with everything going on with Halo, make sure you tap subscribe, everybody. If you missed any content from me recently or been out of the loop for Halo for the last few days or so, check out the videos on the screen right here. Got a link to all my news and informational videos right there. So thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. And I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace out.